When Melissa Pruitt first discovered cat cafes in Japan back in 2008, she knew Arizona needed one. What began as a Kickstarter campaign is now La Gattara Cat Lounge and Boutique. La Gattara means crazy cat lady, and she embraces the name fully. Pruitt says the fact that Arizona has the highest number of cats that are put down a year inspired her to start the business.
And I just want to be a place of education for people, a place of community, and it's really turned into so much more.
Pruitt is most happy about how the cats have affected the people of the community.
There's a lady that comes here and she had just gone through divorce, her dad died, and she said this is what's gotten her through. Because it's like real life Prozac. You can leave everything else outside the door and you come into here, it's like a magical place.
La Gattara hosts many events, including ones for education.
So tonight I hosted a cat behavior chat, basically just a cat behavior 101, going over body language and cat communication. I love the mission of it. It's just a great place for people to come and learn and interact with cats.
Although Pruitt says adoption is not her number one goal, La Gattara is responsible for over 80 adoptions in just the 4 months they've been open.
I think we're at a great animal shelter in Gilbert too, but this whole setup here is just so nice and it's close to the college kids. It gets younger people excited about cats.
The lounge's proximity to Arizona State University brings in a range of people who are able to connect through cats.
When you come in here, there's people that are sitting in circles that don't know each other that are sitting around playing with cats. I mean, where do you get that from? Like, that's amazing.
La Gattara hosts many events, including ones for education, cat yoga, and meowditation. Pruitt is even planning a big cat palooza and a grand opening. But until then, she continues to live by her motto, peace, love, meow. For Cronkite 502, I'm Ashley Mackey.